everybody. Today I'm very excited because it's finally the installation time for my Grizzly winch. After some serious headaches regarding the supporting bar, I finally found one that is somehow suitable for my winch. We will make some adjustments, more or less, but in the end I'm very confident that the whole process will end up as I expect. Thank you. The winch is fully installed. As I said, I was confident that the whole process will end up to be exactly as I wanted, and that's the case. I'm very excited about how the winch support bar came out in the end, and how the winch is fitted on this support bar. I'm very happy because we reinforced that bar, and now when the winch is going to pull the car, it's not going to be just from the upper part of the chassis, but also from the lower part of the chassis. Now let me show you how the winch looks from the outside. So this is a first look at the freshly installed winch, which is reinforced by two different iron bars. One of those bars starts from somewhere at the base of the chassis and goes all the way up to this part on the winch support bar. The winch is at about 10 centimeters under the plate number. Initially I wanted it to install it a little higher so the base of the car won't be lowered and the angle of attack won't be as well lower, but this kind of installation would have required more cutting to the middle part of the front bumper, steel part of the front bumper. Another tricky situation was with the winch control box. So the Duster has a really nice space between the logo and the right or the left headlight, and we ended up using that space to insert the control box. Now let me show you how the winch works. It really rolls up very fast. In order to use the winch remote, you have to first turn it on. You do this by pressing at the same time the in and the out button. Okay, out. It's much faster than the other winches. I'm not sure how much faster it is, but I know that in this particular category of winches, the Grizzly winch is the fastest. There's a downside to this bigger speed of the winch, because when you're trying to winch it up, it's hard to control. So it's kind of difficult to control the winch when you're not using it anymore. You might end up damaging the front bumper if you're not paying attention, or if the winch hook is taken out, this part might end up hitting the radiator grill. About the radiator grill, I think it's very safe with this installation. So another reinforcement we did on the front bumper is made on its side. So the plastic bumper is connected to the lower part of the chassis, mostly because when the car is suspended on its belly, it might be, this side might be damaged. So, this is my video for today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to install a winch on your Duster and you don't know how to choose it, I strongly recommend that you use one that is over 6,000 pounds, because the maximum power of any winch is calculated when the rope is fully taken out of it. So as you winch up and the roller is gathering the rope, the power of the winch is going lower. So the higher the winch, the better is for you to winch it on closed spaces or small distances or something like that. So if you have any other questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section. I hope that in the next video we're going to do some off-road stuff and use the winch so you can see better how it works. Right now, thank you for your time and drive safe. Bye bye.